Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello friends, in my last video I have started application layer of 15CS52 computer network syllabus. So we will continue the session with the topic DNS. So before continuing the topic DNS, let us see first what and all it will cover. It will cover definition, DNS naming structure, DNS components, how DNS works, DNS organization and summary. So before that, we should know IP address, MAC address, port address and utility to check the connectivity, and one more protocol, that is a dynamic host control protocol. So IP address is nothing but a 32-bit address. It is a unique identity for any machine on the internet. In the diagram you can see the machines are connected to the internet through router, and we know this is the network address and this is the IP address of these machines respectively. So now IP address, there are two standards, version 4 and version 6. IP address are represented by 32 bits in dotted decimal notation like this. So IP version 6 uses 128 bits, that is 16 bytes long integers to represent address. So normally, you know, we configure IP address by two ways. One is use the following IP address, where we mention IP address, subnet mask, gateway and DNS server address. Second one is obtain IP address automatically. It will get the address from DHCP server address. For example, I will take you to my machine now. Here, this, if I click on this network card, you can see here internet protocols. Version 6 and 4 are configured already. I will take the version 4 and properties, and you can see here get address automatically. Obtain DNS address automatically means my machine will try to get address from the DHCP server hosted by my ISP, and also along with the IP address it will try to get the default gateway for my machine, and it will also try to get the DNS server address that will resolve the name to IP. So other method is use the following IP address, where you have to mention the IP address, subnet mask, default gateway and DNS server, alternative DNS server, and in the advanced option some other options are there. All those things you have to mention. So this is the way. Now once again go back to our . So as I said, address can be get in two ways. One is to obtain an IP address automatically, use the following address. So once you configure the IP address, as I said in my last video, you have to give you IP config command, and you can see what is the address assigned to your machine. So in this one, you can see the address assigned to your machine is, this is the address. This is the address and this is the subnet mask, and address is received by address. My machine got the address through DHCP server, and the address of the DHCP server is this one, and DHCP server will give the address on list basis. So lease obtained on this date and lease expires on this date. And other than that, this is the physical address and this is the DNS server address. All those informations will be there. So once again here we'll see the TCP or DOD model of network, which has got 5 layers, and all these are different protocols are coming in this layer. Last class we have discussed the important protocol, that is FTP. So in this video we will discuss DNS. DNS comes under name management. Name management, that is name resolution. So all these are comes under application layer of the application layer of our OSA or DOD model. And you see here, application layer has got several protocols. Below the application layer, transport layer has got two protocols, TCP and UDP. So our application layer makes use of one of these protocols, either TCP or UDP. That means it makes use of connection oriented or connectionless protocol. For example, FTP makes use of port number 21 TCP, Telnet through port number 23 TCP, SMTP through port number 25 TCP, and TFTP to port number 69 UDP, SNMP, simple network management protocol, like this, RIP like this. But our DNS makes use of both. So one is for one is TCP, other one is UDP. For one is for name resolution query, and other one is for something like database update and all. For that, it will make use of two protocols, TCP and UDP, and port number is 53. Please remember, port number is 53. So you should know here one more protocol, DHCP. DHCP is a dynamic host configuration protocol. It allows a computer to request an IP address to a DHCP server. So it allows the system administrator to configure IP address automatically. It makes the system administrator free from configuring IP address. So machine will get IP address automatically. Only thing is on the machine you have to enable get address automatically. Then machine will send a broadcast request to DHCP server, and DHCP server will give the IP address on lease basis. So you can see here how DHCP works. Here client try to access wants to get DHCP address. So it should request will go through certain functional components called as relay to DHCP server, and DHCP server will issue the IP address to client. Here there are several DHCP servers are there, so all these servers will offer the IP address, but finally it depends on the client which offer it will accept. So next one is the DNS definition. DNS, domain name system, is a distributed database. It is a mechanism which translates name to address and vice versa. Because in internet, users use DNS to reference anything by name. For example, we will refer like www.google.com, www.microsoft.com rather than IP address, because we cannot remember the IP address of all those different systems. So we'll refer by name. So computer works on address. So this name to address mapping is done by DNS. Domain names are unique, easy to remember. That's why we normally use domain names. Why DNS? Now the question comes, why we need DNS? DNS, it is easier to remember the host name than the remember IP address. Name has more meaning than address. Applications such as email, FTP, HTTP, all makes use of require the user to input destination in the form of name. Application takes the host name supplied by the user and forward it to DNS for the translation and to an IP address. So domain name is, what is domain name? Is a sequence of labels from a node to the root. So here you can see, this is actually, if I say node, either So this is, if I call this is node, or this may be subdomain. So I will write here node pc1.sales.microsoft.com. So domain name is a sequence of labels from node to root. This is root here. Actually, we will not represent this dot while writing. This is called as fully qualified domain name, DN, FQDN. It ends with the root dot always. So you know yahoo.com. This is the domain name. Now, domain name is a subtree for larger tree identified domain name. Domain is a subtree of larger tree identified domain name. Contains resource records and subdomains. For example, you can see domain name DNS server is like distributed it's an hierarchical database which contains root servers. Below root server, you have com DNS server, org DNS server, edu DNS server. Under that, under com, yahoo.com comes, amazon.com, google.com, they have their own DNS servers. Like this, it works. So you have to remember, one domain is the subdomain of another. For example, mn.net.ye is a subdomain of net.ye. google.com is a subdomain of com. So google is a subdomain of com. google.com, google is a subdomain of com. So domains are classified into top level domains. Then top level domains code for country, second level domain. For example, top level domains are something like this one, com or edu. And top level domain name for country is Yemen, YE. Second level domain is .net, Google, all these are second level domain. Like sub level domain occurs here. So you see here top level domains and their purpose here in the diagram. You can see one is com, second one is a commercial organization, educational institution, government, military, major network support center, then country code, etc. So here TLD, top level domain for country, .UK, United Kingdom. Then .fr, France, something like this. So you can sometimes you can see like IN for India. So second level domain is Yahoo, MSN, Microsoft, or all these are called as second level domain. And this is a structure, this is a root, and this is the top level domain. This is the top level domain. These are second level domain. These are the subdomain, and these may I can under this may I can call host. So you can see here, for example, if I write a domain name something like this, challenger.atc.something.edu, then something you see here, challenger is the subdomain. Challenger is the subdomain of ATC. ATC is the subdomain of FSDA. FSDA is the subdomain of EDU. EDU is nothing but top level domain. And above that, we have root level domain. So domain is also, so here you can see in a different diagram, this one. This is one domain. This is also one domain. You can see this is also one domain, and it is also sometimes referred as zone. Zone are administrative spaces Zone is a physical division of namespace. Zone file contains information about a resource. It is the administrative spaces. Administrative means it comes under one administrative authority, something like that. So here you can see, this is one zone. So domain and one net zone. So domain and net zone. So separate zone you can see. Separate zone you can see here. So hierarchy of name servers, root server, then second level and top level, second level domain, all those things you can see. Now naming structure also, you can see this naming structure here. So root name servers, there are around 13 root name servers are there in the world. So what is the use of this one? Your local name server that cannot resolve the name will contact the root name server and try to get the mapping. And root name server gets the mapping, contacts the authority name server, returns mapping to the local name server. All this done by this one. So domain naming structure, you can see this is the top level domain, this is the second level domain, and this is the top level country code. Other than that, if you mention dot, then it is called as a root level. Normally we will not mention dot. Top level domain servers responsible for COM, org, net, EDU, etc. And it will maintain network solution, maintain servers for COM, TLD, EDU cost for EDU, TLD. All those are maintains mapping for COM and particular this one, top level domains. Authoritative DNS server, organizations DNS server providing authoritative host name to IP mapping. For example, suppose particular organization or particular ISP or particular organization, they can have their own DNS server that is called as authoritative DNS server that also provides the mapping. So several types of name servers are there. One is authority server. As I said, authority servers are master, primary and secondary. Sometimes if the primary is not working, then secondary will take charge. Then recursive, etc. Local name server does not strictly belong to hierarchy. Normally with the ISP or with particular organization, when host makes a DNS query, it normally goes to local name server. So in DNS query, there are two types. One is called as iterated. Second one is a recursive. You can see here, host at cis poly.edu wants IP address of this one. That means, see here, this host wants the IP address of this one. This one. That means this host wants to contact this one. So it will send the request first to local DNS server. So if the local DNS server is able to, local DNS server for this domain, poly.edu is nothing but dns.poly.edu. If it can resolve the query, then okay. Otherwise, how it works, we will see now. First, the request goes to local DNS server. If it cannot solve, then it will go to root DNS server. And from the root DNS server, reply comes. Root DNS server says, I don't know this name, but you can ask top level DNS server. That is here, top level DNS server is EDU. So now it will contact authority of a top level DNS server, EDU. EDU says it doesn't know about this address, but it know the authority DNS server of authority DNS server for this domain. for this domain. So now my machine contacts authority DNS server for this domain, that is cs.ums.edu. This DNS server knows the address of this one. It will give the address, and our local DNS server return the address to our machine. Our machine will contact now the server. The machine. So DNS server contains different types of records. The records are classified as start of authority, name server, A type, and canonical name, and MX. So what are the different types of records? See, this type A record you see, which contains host name, A type authority, A type record, address record, and address. For example, icicbank.com, www.icicbank.com, this is the address. Now, concept of resolving process and cache. So, here resolver wants to know the address of www.rip.net.a. In the recursive method, it will try to contact the root server, or in the recursive or iterated method, it will try to contact the root server and try to get the information. That information is stored in the cache for the future use. So all these informations are stored in the cache for the future use. So next time when the request comes, all those cache informations are used. You can see here, resource records, this one, format, that is, label is something like this, and it is a type of A, resource record, and its address is this one, and TTL is 3600. So canonical name means sometimes it is called as alias name, alias. For example, it says here www.force.ye. This also can be called by other name, that is eServer.force.in. So if you, instead of typing www.force.in or ye, if you type eServer.force.in or ye, that also possible, that is called as canonical. So for this name, also called by one more name, that is eServer. This name is normally called by one more name. This is eServer, that is called alias record. MX refers the mail exchange server address. For example, yahoomail.com or gmail.com, they have got separate mail, that is they have mail server. That server's address is represented in the DNS server, something like this. For example, if this is the mail server, then it is represented by type MX, and this is the full name. So how DNS servers works on the works? Suppose you type this one, you type www.google.com. From your machine, the query goes to your ISP for a recursive DNS server. ISP, they have got a DNS server. It is something like, tell me the address of www.google.com. Then suppose if the ISP doesn't know, ISP's recursive name server starts by asking one of the root server. If it doesn't know, it will ask by one of the root server. For example, root server. Root server says, I don't know the address, but I know who is authority for the com domain. Ask them. Now, my ISP will contact authority for com DNS servers. which says, I don't know address, but I know who is authority for google.com domain. Ask them. Now, ISP will ask google.com DNS server, what is the address of www.google.com? So he says, like the address of www.google.com is this one. Now my PC will contact www.google.com by using port number 80, HTTP protocol. In this way, this is resolved. How your mail works? For example, how your mail works? Next. You see here, you will send the mail. From your PC, the mail, outbound mail, goes to SMTP server. For example, you want to send this message, for example, some message to someone at the example.com. So first mail will be stored in, for example, your mail address is, suppose, a@gmail.com. Then this mail is stored in this mail server, Gmail mail server, it is stored first. That is called as SMTP server. From that server, it has to be forwarded to someone at the example.com. How would this works? We have to see now. First, before sending mail, to example.com mail server, your mail server, that means you have account with Google mail, Google, that is a@gmail.com. Then you have one mailbox in Google server, and your mail will be in Google server, mail server. From there, the mail goes. First, your Google mail server try to resolve the name of example.com. So it will ask first local ISP, ISP DNS server. If the ISP DNS server doesn't know, then it will ask the root DNS server, and procedure follows as I said earlier. Now your mail server may come to know that the mail server address for example.com is mx10.example.com. This is the mail server for example.com domain. Your mail server came to know through your DNS server, that contacted example.com DNS server, and from that it came to know the mail server address is MX10. So now mail will be sent. So now next one is a DNS organization. DNS organizations are maintained by Internic, Internet Network Information Center. So Internet formally handled all domain name registration. Network Solution, a private company, processed the registration. Now it is called as VeriSign. Now several companies can register domain names. And also IP addresses are managed by ICANN, that is Internet Corporation for Assigned Name and Numbers. So with this, we will end this session. So please remember, DNS is an integral part of the most protocol used in the internet. Makes the internet human friendly for all, for us all. It is the world's largest distributed database system. Fits the international models perfectly. In simple terms, it is the mapping between names and IP address. This is a summary of the session. Thank you.